So then I went to work after I finally read these books and started optimizing every little piece of it, okay, using my hyperanalytical abilities, breaking out of that introversion, coming to a more extroverted place, more confident place. And it's funny now because the girls that I know in the modern day, I'm like, yeah, I used to be super fucking shy. I'm actually like a huge closet nerd. And they're like, no way, I don't believe you, blah, 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 blah. What's up, guys? John Anthony here from John Anthony Lifestyle. Today I want to talk about how I was in high school and how I was before I got into the game. And a lot of you will be able to relate to this. I was extremely, extremely shy, introverted, awkward, okay, with lots, riddled with anxiety disorders and this and that. Terrified to talk to anyone, including even any guys, any person in general, okay? I'm gonna get into all those details, but before we continue, if you are new to the channel, and not yet a subscriber, please subscribe below. New videos every day around 2 p.m. Eastern time. Press the notification bell for alerts to those new videos every day. And if you'd like to master the game, jump on a free 30-minute call, and me or one of my coaches will walk you through how we can get you very good, very fast, from no matter what level you're at, how to get you to a very advanced level in as little time as possible. So jump on that free 30-minute call to go over those details, okay? So in high school, there was a graduating class size in my final year of high school of about 700 people. I was one of the most shy people out of all those different students. I was diagnosed with general anxiety disorder, with social anxiety disorder, with panic disorder, with obsessive compulsive disorder, okay, not like ritualistic obsessive compulsive, but just like looping thoughts, which has been a blessing and a curse. It's what allows me to hyperanalyze everything because I can distill everything down into its component parts and put everything through the whole analysis ringer in my brain. Okay, one of the psychologists that I talked to said that most people's thoughts go from here to here and mine gets stuck in loops. Okay, so I relentlessly analyze things, which is extremely good for solving problems, but it can be a social detriment. And the different anxiety disorders, that's kind of tripping the fight or flight response through the amygdala fear circuit in the brain. Okay, this is why I was drinking on almost a daily basis for about 15 years, because it would kind of quiet all that stuff down, chill things out, chill down the mental chatter, and allow me to interact on a more, you know, on a level where I wasn't always like, oh my God, right? And I grew out of that. I don't need alcohol anymore. I didn't need it for a long time, but in the early days it was very helpful to kind of break me out of that shell. I didn't even start drinking until my third year of college. But I went into undergraduate, into my first year of college, not having kissed a girl, not having had sex, not having done anything hookup wise with any girl ever. Okay. I had my first kiss and I was like literally trembling, no bullshit, in like October of my first year of college. Okay, and I lost my virginity at the end of my first year of college around like May of like 2002 or so. Going into my third year of college, I'd only been with three girls. Okay, so it was a very, very slow start, but I want to go back and look at what was going on in high school. Okay, so my final year of college, I was playing the violin. Okay, I was in orchestra, I played the violin for 8 years. I was in math league, okay, I was winning all these math competitions. I was in chess club, I was day trading stocks, I was sneaking out of the lunchroom to day trade stocks. They had these wireless chess applications. This was before like wireless, this was before like the internet. There were wireless devices on phones were available, okay? So not the internet, but wireless phones being able to play each other in different things. We had these special devices that had a certain range and we would play chess against each other while we were in AP classes. I was playing lots of video games, okay? That's what I was doing with most of my free time. I was also reading a lot of books on philosophy and science and you know, just learning knowledge in general. And poker, that's when I started getting really into poker as well. But I would sit with like two guys at lunch who were like the nerdiest guys in school along with myself. One of them ended up on going to do a PhD program in quantum physics, specializing in string theory, which he dropped out of. Now he's living on a boat and trying to compile minimalist distributions of Linux. Okay, talk about extremely nerdy. And then I had the other guy that I was close with. He ended up going on to be a lawyer. We both took the LSAT together, got into a law program together. He ended up seeing it through and became a lawyer in New York City, working on big settlements against pharmaceutical companies, et cetera, multi-year processes for class action lawsuits against these pharmaceutical companies. But we would just sit at lunch, the three of us, we'd debate different science and philosophy topics. I was in like seven different advanced placement classes, college level classes, as a senior in high school. And it was just like fucking nerd central. Like, like no contact with any women, no I was extremely shy. I had like trouble even looking people in the eyes. I had panic attacks and panic disorders so bad at a certain point that it was hard for me to even leave the house. Okay, so this is why I sympathize with a lot of guys that I've worked with over the past 10 years. I was in most of your shoes, if not much worse. Okay, I was getting panic attacks to the point where I would dread leaving the house, okay? Because I didn't want to be in public and away from like the comfort of being at home when I'm like fucking hyperventilating and having panic attacks and all this shit, okay? In the modern day, I do take anxiety medicine. I take Effexor, E-F-F-E-X-O-R. I tried a bunch of stuff and I had different clients that were trying stuff as well. And that one seems to really just take the anxiety away. It doesn't just diminish it, it pretty much just eliminates it. So if you are, you know, this isn't medical advice, I'm not a doctor, but that's what worked for me. I encourage you guys, if you're having problems with general anxiety, social anxiety, you know, beyond just like some minimal normal things that everybody experiences, if it's like a perpetual problem that's interfering with your life, I highly suggest you talk to your doctor, psychologist about trying out Effexor. Okay, which it's a SNRI, not to be confused with an SSRI. An SSRI is a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor. Okay, whereas Effexor is a selective norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. Okay, and it helps with like depression as well. I had depression as well pretty badly in high school. I was facing a lot of verbal abuse from my mother as I was going through, you know, middle school and in high school and stuff like this, and I didn't have the financial means to move out of the house, so I was enduring a lot of that. And I think that's what kind of created the perfect storm, is these hyper-analytical intellectual abilities coupled with this relentless verbal abuse, which gave me that drive and ignition component to see things, you know, through to such an extreme in the game. Okay, a lot of the best, I do martial arts as well. I do Krav Maga and Muay Thai and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and some Machida Karate, Shotokan Karate, and some of the best martial artists in the world, like Georges St. Pierre and the UFC, he was like relentlessly bullied as a child, and then he went on to become one of the greatest fighters in the world, if not the greatest. Okay, and this I see this in the community. A lot of the best guys had pretty hardcore, like fucked up childhoods. Okay, that kind of left this void, this need for validation, this need for approval. And that's what kind of unleashed the beast in order to take this game to the extreme. So I do acknowledge that on some level, you know, it wasn't like the healthiest drive component to be kind of, you know, searching for maybe the love that my mother never provided. However, it did do the trick. Okay, so a lot of these things are double-edged sword. Like, it sucks having grown up with general anxiety and social anxiety, but it also made me exceptional at analyzing and solving problems. Okay, far greater than almost everybody I've ever met. Okay, and a lot of what's cool is a lot of the smartest people I've met throughout my life think that I'm much smarter than them once we've gotten to know each other. And, you know, I think if I would have quit drinking a lot sooner, I could have taken things, you know, my life has pretty much gone up exponentially since I quit drinking. But that is why I was relying on alcohol for a long time, because of the general anxiety and social anxiety. And just like two or three drinks really slashes away approach anxiety, really gets you from like stops you from overanalyzing, allows you to just flow, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm one of the only coaches that still recommends alcohol, even though I had a problem with it. As long as you can drink responsibly and not get carried away with it, where you're drinking too often or in too much quantities, it can be very good to have a couple drinks to wipe away approach anxiety and put you more in a headspace where you're able to free flow vibe and stuff like that, and not judge what you're saying and these kinds of things. But I've conditioned myself out of that anyways from running thousands of interactions. There's almost 14,000 phone numbers in my phone. But I wanted to share with you guys the place that I came from, because a lot of these people in this space, a lot of them are just pure internet marketers, for one. So they never had to go through all these struggles. They never had to learn game. They don't have any game in the first place. And there's some other coaches that happen to be naturals, or they were always cool, or they were getting laid in high school, this and that. I came from a place of extreme anxiety, extreme introversion, depression. I thought I was hopeless. And I also was raised very Catholic, so I was planning on waiting till marriage to have sex, if you can believe it or not. And I also plan on never having a drink in my entire life. I literally went into college with these beliefs, because I came from an Irish Catholic and Polish Catholic, hardcore Catholicism on both sides, on my dad's side, my mom's side. My parents both waited till marriage to have sex, and that's how we were raised as well. Okay, we weren't even allowed to swear in the house. I remember even in high school, we weren't allowed to watch shows like The Simpsons because of inappropriate themes and swearing and stuff like that. So it was like a tough process. When I got into college, I was able to kind of break out of the shell and become more extroverted and this and that. Even before I started drinking, I was able to become more extroverted when I didn't have kind of this like you know, tight sheltering from the parents involved. But I wanted to share this with you guys. A lot of you guys have been following me for years. Some of you may be new to the channel, but I want you guys to be aware that I feel your pain. I went through that shit. Kind of the big turning point for me was I had won this big poker tournament and I had a bunch of money from the earnings. And I went right after the poker tournament with a bunch of friends. We went out to the bar and I was paying for everybody's drinks, all my friends in the group. And I was trying to talk to a bunch of girls and it was just like nonstop blowouts. And I remember coming back home with my best friend at the time and I was like, dude, I was like, that fucking sucked. I was like riding this whole high from winning that fucking tournament. And we all went out to the bar and we just got fucking destroyed all night. And I was like, there has to be a better way. And he's like, yeah. He's like, that was really rough. And I'm like, dude, there has to be a fucking better way. And then, believe it or not, the dude that ended up going on to do the PhD in quantum physics and specializing in string theory, he's the one that was pushing me to read the book The Game, and later pushing me to read Mystery Method. And at first, I was like, no, that sounds like bullshit. I thought it sounded like a scam. I thought it sounded too good to be true. I didn't believe there could be a method to the madness, okay? But, and for those of you that still doubt that Game works, okay, which I have thousands of counterexamples to anyone that thinks that Game isn't a thing, just ask yourself these simple questions. Are there better ways to approach a woman than not? Are there better ways to run an interaction than not? To do your sexualization, to do your physicality, to set up things for her to come home with you? Are there better ways to, are there better texts than others? Yes, of course. Are there better sequences of texts than others? Yes, of course. And you can measure all this stuff scientifically. You can measure the results that these text sequences produce. Out of 10 dates, are running even more, a bigger sample size, what percentage of my phone numbers will turn into dates? What percentage of my dates will turn into girls coming home with me? What percentage of the girls that come home will turn into closes and hookups? What percentage of the girls that I close can I retain? So then I went to work after I finally read these books and started optimizing every little piece of it, okay, using my hyperanalytical abilities, breaking out of that introversion, coming to a more extroverted place, more confident place. And it's funny now because the girls that I know in the modern day, I'm like, yeah, I used to be super fucking shy. I'm actually like a huge closet nerd. And they're like, no way, I don't believe you, blah, 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 blah. Because right now, I'm usually at the life of the party. I'm usually, you know, extremely extroverted, even without alcohol. And everybody's always laughing, all the shit, I'm always cracking jokes. But for those of you that are in that place right now, where you have anxiety and you have introversion and you're unsure of yourself and this and that, know that it can and will get better. I think that Effexor really helped a lot. But also just throwing yourself into social situations, making sure you speak up, that you're not just kind of this meek, passive observer floating along through life, okay? And as you start to get results with women, okay, once you receive the proper training, of course, then that's going to be empirical, demonstrable proof that yes, you can do this stuff, yes, it is possible, yes, you're not, you know, this special case that this stuff doesn't work for, okay? So I wanted to share that background. I had a recent video where I talked about my educational background and the different paths that I went before arriving at a dating coach, but I want you guys to know that I came from an extreme place of introversion as well, where I was going to different psychologists trying to solve these anxiety problems, trying to solve the depression problems in the past, and this and that. Okay, I was even suicidal at one point in high school. I had to go to the guidance counselor every week and tell them I was gonna kill myself, right? It literally got that bad. So, those days are far behind, and I've grown into a much different person now, and I'm really happy at the place I'm at in life now, okay? But I never would have dreamed in my wildest dreams that I would have banged, the time of this recording is 1,374 girls, okay? And I never ever would have dreamed of that. So dare to dream. I promise you, a lot of you are in a much, even if you're in a very shy, introverted place, or you have no results or very minimal results, I was much worse off, okay? And I went through all the blood, sweat, and tears to optimize the system. And now when I have guys sign up that are virgins or that have very minimal results, or even advanced guys. I'm gonna do a testimonial this week on my channel where there's a 300 lay count guy in the program, and I've provided massive upgrades to his system. And he's like, dude, I came on not expecting you to do very much in terms of, you know, he really loves my material and all this stuff, but he's like, at 300 girls, I thought I had the game pretty figured out. And I identified a whole bunch of big holes that literally, like, on an X factor, like 3-4x a lot of his results. He's now getting like far more dates with far more high quality girls. He's retaining far more, etc. So we're gonna go over, even at an advanced level, how I can provide a ton of value to you. It's not often that I get students like that. Most guys are nowhere near that level. And also, everyone thinks, you know, once they get to like 50 girls or 100 girls, which isn't that common either, a lot of people think they have it all figured out. I talk to guys every week that are in single digit lay count, think they have it all figured out. I don't even think I have it all figured out. Okay, at 1,374 goals. And I think it's paramount to be humble and think that the game is never mastered, because there's always ways to improve and to grow. So my point is that when I get these guys to go on the program now, I plug them into the end state of my most optimized texting and online game sequences, the end state of my best strategy for cold approach, for running dates, closing dates, retaining, etc. So this stuff works extremely, extremely well, extremely fast, and you get to bypass that whole process, and you get to break out of the introversion and confidence problems and security problems very fucking quick. Okay, most guys I work with have all those problems, and I know them very, very well, not just from experiencing them personally so I can relate to you guys, but also because I've trained so many guys. I've been coaching this for over 10 years. A lot of these fucking retards on YouTube, for lack of a better term, are brand new on the scene. And they don't know what the fuck they're doing. They don't have the results or the experience to back any of the shit they're talking about. I listen to 5 minutes to their videos, any of their videos, and I know for sure they're way off with their theory. And usually that's exactly what it is, just abstract theory that has no practical application. And so, you know, and that's why guys always, like, when they finally get on a call with me or they work with me or they meet me in person, they're like, dude, you're really down to earth. You're really chill. And a lot of my videos, I put off this big asshole persona, et cetera, when I'm doing roasts and this and that. But that's just to fucking, you know, I get charged up when I'm pissed off at these guys making a mockery of the game and scamming people and being fake gurus and ripping people off, et cetera. So, you know, the thing is that you're literally just like a week or two away, no matter what level you're at, to start having your schedule fully packed out with girls. Okay, so if you're ready for that, jump on a free 30-minute call. It's free, no obligation. I'll go through the whole game plan of how I can get you there very fast. And you can be another success story of going on track to do 50 to 100 girls a year. Okay, but I think you guys will get a lot of insight out of this 300 lay count guy sharing his story. And he's only about halfway through the program, but he's already made a whole ton of levelings up. And I told him to kind of identify where those are. And we're going to go through all those in a video this week, which should be very informative. Okay, but I don't put myself on a pedestal. A lot of these coaches, and you know, there's tons of guys that suck, almost all of them. They act like they're all high and mighty and too cool, and they put down the guys and all this stuff. I see myself on the same level. Okay, and I think that I'm by far the best coach and by far the best pickup artist in the game. Okay, and I have all the results to back that. But that doesn't mean I'm better than any of these guys that I work with or anything like that. So, you know, because I went through all that shit. I remember very well how bad those times sucked and how it seemed like there was no hope and how it seemed I was totally fucked, right? And I thought there was never going to be any chance to get hot girls or even average girls. So it is possible. I'm doing it on a weekly basis for lots of guys. If you're ready, jump on that free 30-minute call. If you don't have any kind of decent budget to do an 8-week training program, then I have product links in the description as well and in the pinned comment. Please like, comment, and share if you haven't already. Please subscribe if you are not yet a subscriber. Press the notification bell for new videos. More roasts coming soon. I kind of took a little bit of a break from those because everyone was complaining they wanted more value content, which I've provided very extreme over the past couple weeks. So we will jump back into some roasts mixed in with the value content. Okay? Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you on the next video. Take care. Some do it for the income, but we do it for the outcome. Some of us are active while others just let their mouth run. No doubt, son, this is not just about fun. We will not be outdone by these cowards who shout scum.